Mate, your old mate Mickey. Here, Jack, have a look. You never guess who it is. It's only young Danny.
Danny?
Yeah.
Danny? The fuck's he doing in the moat with Tony and Pat?
Yes, Dan. What are you doing in the moat with Tony and Pat? I thought you had more sense than that.
I don't know what you're talking about. Don't know no Tony. That was me mate Jeff.
Are you telling us that ain't Tony T? Jack, what do you reckon?
Don't know, Mickey. I shot him in the face.
Oh.
No. Oh, mate, what a fucking mess. I'm so sorry, Dan. I feel so embarrassed. How about the other geezer in the back?
Paul.
Jack?
You.
Did you shoot the other geezer in the...
Yep. Shot him in the face, too.
I don't know what to say, mate. I feel terrible. Terrible. Look at your motor. I've left it in the right turn, ain't I?
It's all right.
No, it ain't, then. Because there's blood.
Brains.
And brains. And that ain't never gonna come out. Probably them, isn't it? Right, Dan, listen, we've got to slip away. But, you'll be lucky, yeah? Right, Jack, let's crack on, son.
Let's do it.
Third time lucky.
It was the end of an era. Well, for them lot anyway. For me, it was only the beginning. But before the pills and the clubs, the birds, the booze, the torture and the tracksuits, there was football. And more importantly, football-related violence. Because as far back as I could remember, I always wanted to be an hooligan.
An earthquake is erupting, but not in Orange Street. A ghost dance is preparing, you've got to help us with your feet. Not in the mood to dance, step back, grab yourself a seat. This may not be uptown Jamaica, but we promise you a treat. Bust a bummy other with your bogus dance and shuffle me off my feet. Even though I keep on running, I never get to Orange Street. So I set up myself to say, for the man who set the beat. So I leave it up to you out there to get him back off his feet. On the other with your bogus dance and shuffle me off my feet. Even though I keep on running, I never get to Orange Street.
suppose we better start near the beginning. School. What a shithole. But we made the most of it. Oh, have a look. That's me there. That's me best mate, Fanta. And this wanker is Mr. Burrows.
Something funny, Johnson?
No, sir.
Passing notes. Come on, then. Come up to the front. We're all very keen to share the joke.
Yes, sir.
Like I said, wanker.
It says that you had...
To the whole class.
It says that you had Freddie Fitzpatrick run your ass for extra maths tuition.
Really, Johnson?
And that you made him watch while you touched your willy. And then bent him over and tongued his bottle.
Anything else?
Yeah, there's a picture here and all. Well, that's you, sir. And that's obviously you, Freddie.
Johnson, you're going to end up just like your father.
Now, this didn't sound like such a bad thing to me, but I got the feeling he meant it as an insult.
You want to make one of me, son, do you?
That's me old man, Danny Senior, the fucking legend.
You want to make one of me? Do you know who I am? Do you know who I am? What are you looking at? Come on,
Eric, it was a shame you had to ruin the game, though, because I weren't a bad little player.
Right, it's fucking on now.
A scout from Man United came to our school once and tried to get me to sign.
Do me a favour there, son. That mob are never going to amount to nothing.
Hold that bush.
Mr. Johnson, this is school, Mr. Johnson.
Yep, my old man loved football.
Never back down, son.
So I took a leaf at the old man's book and said,
fuck off, you two-bob slag.
Of course, it turns out Burrows was fiddling Freddie Fitzpatrick after all, and they told me I could come back to school. But fuck that.
Mr. Johnson, due to your complete lack of remorse for your crime and your repeated failure to show any signs of wanting to change your lifestyle, I sentence you to 5 years without possibility of parole. Bailiff, take the prisoner down.
5 years. He could have done it standing on his head.
Order!
He ended up getting 30 years for headbutting the bailiff, spitting on the clerk at a court, booting his gingerbird in the face and assaulting the judge.
Fucking nuts!
The newspaper said he was the first man in history to make a judge eat his own cereal. Fucking legend. And with me still a boy, I was sent to live with me granddad Albert, while me old man was sent to do his bird.
What's I'm still doing this gap for? Mate, keep moving, scumbag. What the fuck's that all about then?
No, no, 4737. We don't want any trouble like we had last year. The boys here have all clubbed together. Bought you a little hat, to say sorry. Very well. Happy birthday, 4737. Enjoy your cake.
Nobody beats off my door a morning time, you know. Wait, what's your name? What's for dinner? I am fucking Hank Marvin.
I
fuck's all this then, Granddad?
What the fuck's all this? What are you talking about, you dozy little mill? I told you, I'm moving to Australia with Cyril.
Since when?
I told you months ago to get your own place. What have you been doing all this time, Sitting on your ass smoking weed with that ginger faggot?
I thought I could just live here.
I told you, Dan. I sold the place, moving to warmer climes. Nothing left for me round here.
Well, what am I supposed to do?
Time to grow up, son. Make something of your life. Do the fucking collar, get some readies.
So what are you gonna do then?
Don't take this the wrong way, mate. But recently I've been starting to think there's got to be something more than this.
You ain't gonna get a job, are you?
And what I'm saying is my man was a legend. A face. Look at me. You know, I want to be someone. I want to be part of something.
OK, here's another one. Oi, mate!
This has been fun and all, mate, but I've got to chip back home and pick up my stuff.
Oh, damn, mate, why don't you stay around mine a couple of days just so you get back on your feet?
Nah, don't worry about me, mate, I'm sweet. This time next week, I'll bet you from your penthouse.
Yeah?
Yeah, fucking right, mate. We'll have a proper party. Birds, booze, the lot.
Bastard, oh, mate. Here we go, have a look. Oi, love!
Oh, fuck off, you pair of melts. That's the oldest trick in the book.
Yeah, anyway, as I was saying, go get your stuff and I'll meet you later on. We can have a few bevvies, celebrate your independence. On me. Fancy an ice cream?
Yeah, go on in, mate.
What flavour?
Anything. Don't get lemon.
All right.
Time to go, 4737. You're a free man today.
No more trouble now, you hear?
Fuck off, screw.
Oh, fuck, fuck, fuck! Jeep! Barry, it's happened again! Fuck it, my charge is on fire, Dave! Ah, fucking burning!
Chop, chop. We're gonna nip through our brand's tunnels, quicker.
Hello. Fuck. Karen! Karen!
All right, what's the matter?
Get the fucking kids out of here! Go round to your mum's and don't come back till I call you.
All right.
Oh, shit! Quick, kids! Get your fucking coats or we're going to your grand's! Oh, for fuck's sake, not again!
I told you, never call my mobile. I've got kids for fuck's sake! But now they're out of the way.
Listen to this.
Hola, my little Spanish prince.
Tickle my front bottom, mate.
What? Oh, yeah. I'm getting huge for you.
Pablo, I want you to fuck me like you did
in Torremolinos. Do you remember,
boy?
Aaron?
Who the fuck is there?
It's Dex.
Who?
It's Dex.
Hold on a minute. Dexy boy.
Baron!
Finally let you out, did they?
Oh, yeah, I'm out.
And I'm coming for you!
Oh, yeah. Oh, I think you'll find a lot's changed since you went in.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Your mob's a fucking joke, son. I wonder...
I've got top firm now.
You're gonna get cut, Baron!
And it's gonna be me that does it!
Fucking hell. You couldn't hit water if you fell out a boat.
I'm gonna slit you open like an envelope.
You couldn't afford the postage.
Yeah, I can! And I send it recorded delivery and all!
Oh, in that case...
I won't be here to sign for it.
Fuck! Fuck! Fuck, 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 fuck! Fuck you, Baron! Fuck it!
You sure about this, mate?
Of course, mate, it's a shortcut. What's the matter? You shook?
Well, yeah, a bit.
Come on, you Mel! What's there to be scared of?
Well, in for one.
Oh. Stay with me if you like.
Look through a magnifying glass, it's a lamp in the bowl.
Come on, show me, bollocks! Every time I stroke them. Come on, Dan. What did I tell you? Ain't that bad, is it? All right. That's Monkey Keith, that is. Sweet.
Now, I knew we shouldn't have gone down that tunnel. But little did I know what would happen now would change my life forever.
You need to stop being such a pussy. You're in safe hands on my boat, mate.
Give me a cigarette.
Sorry, mate, we don't smoke.
We. Fuck.
Well, give me your wallet and I'll buy my own cigarettes.
I'd never been mugged before, but in that moment I thought what my old man had taught me.
Never back down, son! Or stand down!
No.
What do you mean, no?
I mean, no, Kojak. Now, if you want my wallet, you're gonna have to come and take it. You pea-leaded sight.
It felt good. I felt powerful. My old man was right. Never back down. Never give him an inch. Oh, I realised I would have never stood up to this guy before. I saw the fear wash over him like a... Oh, shit.
Nah, you've got me, little shite. Let's get something straight. This... ain't a skinhead. It's alopecia.
Yep.
It's a medical condition. I've lived with this all my life. Yep. Look at it! Have you any idea what it's like growing up a hairless child?
No.
Hairless!
I'm really sorry, mate.
Too late now. Now, you're gonna get cut.
You, me. Ah!
Face him back there. I could have handled it, but the power left me high and dry.
Was that ginger boy I saw at the other end of the tunnel?
Yeah. Yeah, was he all right?
No. He was crying. And some geezer was stroking him. How's the nose, mate?
It's all right. Took me stuff, though. Everything I own was in that bag.
Oh, still. You'll live. did well back there, son. You stood your ground. And that's the most important thing.
Thanks.
I'm Dexter.
Yeah, I know. I'm Danny.
Of course I knew who he was. Dad told me stories all about Dex and his crew when I was a kid. They were the hardest football firm in the country, and Dex, he was their top boy.
Come on.
This is me.
Oh, right. Yeah. Well, I guess I see it around then, yeah?
Danny.
Yeah?
You wanna come for a pint?
Yeah, mate, yeah. Sweet.
Come on in.
What else was I gonna do on a Saturday? What an honour. I was walking into the legendary Iron Hoof with a man of the hour. I felt drunk. Oh, my head was spinning. This is what I've been searching for, to belong. Everyone wanted to talk to Dex, and because I was with him, they all wanted to talk to me. It was like a family, and he introduced me to everyone. There was Dexie and me, and there was Billy Bobells.
Welcome home, Dex.
Oh, the bells.
Scrimshank Stanley.
Looking good, sir.
Knees up Leroy Brown and his half-brother, Andy Old Iron.
Come toilet, got something for you.
His business associate, Little Boy Blue, and his boys, Nicky Mince Pies and Freddie the Nonce.
All right, Dex. Who's your little mate?
Then there was Jimmy Two Times. He got that name because he said everything twice.
Going to get a current bun, current bun.
A lot of the lads got their names that way, like Pete the Killer.
Should carry that thing for you.
Mike the Rapist.
There you go, ladies. One for you and one for you.
His sister, Rita the Maneater. And John the Cunt. But they were just extras. In the back room, I was about to meet the real top boys. The ones that struck fear into the hearts of every other footballer living in the country. The factory.
You ready?
Oh, we didn't need to ask.
I'm ready. Are you gonna be all right tonight because you're with me? You do not want to be in there on your own. Understand? Welcome to my world, son.
All right, Dex.
Oh, hello, mate.
What the fuck is this? I thought it was going to be a pie! Yay! Too fucking right.
Midnight. Back in the day, was the original Black Hooligan.
Come on in, you fucking two-buff dozen!
In fact, I think he was the only Black Hooligan.
Have I jump off your blood clot?
He made a name for himself when he ran onto the pitch in a cup final.
Come on, let's fucking have him!
And tried to kidnap Portsmouth's mascot, the Pompey Pigeon, with an homemade shank.
Get back! I'll kill him! I'll fucking kill him!
Fucking legend.
Dex, welcome home. You're looking sweet, son. This is all with you, bruv. Who's your mate?
It's the boy Danny.
All right, Dan. Anything you want, son. Bird's booze, bit of the other. Just let me know, all right?
Sweet.
Hey, Dexie! Hold on, mate. I'm coming over.
Trumpet. Part of the new breed of football hooligan. Prides himself on the fact he's never even been to a football match, never misses a tear-up, and he's seen Green Street 2,140 times.
Oh, I'm telling you, mate, it's better than the original. Well, I crack on, son.
But he's a fucking thief, and he'll nick anything that's not nailed down.
I'll tell you Thursday, Shell. All right, Trumpet. Ah!
Thank Christ you're back, Dex. Things have been all too quiet, but now the king's return, we can have a proper tear-up. Give me a chance to bring him a new trumpet.
It's good to see you, Trumpet.
Who the fuck are you?
That's Danny.
Say the word, Dex, and I'll carve your name in his boat.
I appreciate the thought, Trumpet, I really do. But he's all right, he's with me.
Yeah? Hold out your hand.
Hey?
Hold your fucking hand out and let me see how old you are.
Gemini. Oh, he's good.
Sweet.
That is good.
Fucking hell, that is unbelievable. How'd you do that?
A magician never reveals his secrets. Oh, and by the way, you're one step away from a free corner of the cob at Pat Mapulek's Chicken Palace. That's a touch.
He's got my wallet, ain't he?
Afraid so, son.
The thing about Weasel is, he didn't have the best start in life. His mum had been having a fling with a young boy called John, but she had to break it off when her fella got her pregnant. To say young John took it badly would be a bit of an understatement.
Baby, relax, baby. I did this to prove how much I love you. I love you, baby. I did this for both of us.
Poor bastard never stood a chance. He was a crackhead before he was even born.
Fucking result!
Right, Dex, mate, you look a bit down.
No, I'm sweet, son. Sweet. Look, I'm glad I got you on your own, because I want to talk to you about my missus.
Why? What's your word?
Well, you took care of her and that while I was inside.
Oh. Right. Think nothing of it, bruv. I don't want to seem ungrateful, mate. But as you know, it's a long time gone.
Too long, mate.
Fucking right, too long. And while I was inside, I had one thing on my mind and one thing only.
The Baron.
Baron. Now he needs to get what's coming to him.
Yeah.
When I left, we were the most violent, bloodthirsty bunch of cunts in London. Now tell me, Midnight, where do we stand? When was the last time we had a proper tear-up?
Funny thing is, mate, recently, when we shop for a ruck, we get a reception from Plod.
Yeah?
Yeah. How long's that been going on?
Dunno. A couple of years.
Fucking filth.
Well, I mean, we'll take Plod by surprise. Yeah. When's the rest of the boys coming, Dan?
Well, this is it, mate.
What do you mean, this is it? Where's the old guard? Where's Bobby Iron?
He got ironed out.
By who?
Where's Stan?
The Irons?
Yeah.
What about Tommy Gunn?
Gunn down.
Arsenal.
What the Gunners?! Next thing you'll be telling me, Midnight, is that Barry the Hammer got beaten to death with his own hammer on the steps of Upton Park!
So you read about it, then?
No, I didn't fucking read about it, Midnight!
At least no one went down to Fulham, eh? Cottaging. You know, Fulham. Cottages.
What do you know about the cottages, boy?
Nothing. It's just a joke, mate.
As you probably know by now, I weren't one for backing down. But I weren't stupid either. I knew who this was. This was Bullet. Dex's right-hand man and a total nutter.
First of all, I ain't your fucking mate, boy. And second, the cottagers ain't no joke. You don't know you're born, do you? You ever been down there?
Oh, the cottagers?
Yeah, the big boys. 'Cause I have. I've been there. We all have, ain't we, boys?
Yeah.
Balls deep in shit. Hands grabbing at you from all angles, faces screaming. People you've never even met before coming right in your face. That's when you find out who your mates are. They're the ones who are right behind you. Packed in, tight. That's what separates us real men from little puffs like you. So come on then, Dex, who's the dry lunch?
Drop me, Matt, put it. He's just a kid.
Welcome home, son.
Who the fuck are you?
This is Bill.
Hello, hello, hello. Pleasure to meet you at last, Dex.
What's the problem, Dex?
What's the problem, Dex? You're amongst friends now, mate.
Am I?
Of course you are. This geezer's old Bill.
He's been inside too long. He's getting paranoid.
Dex, he's sweet, mate.
Old Bill's been following us about for a while now.
How long?
A couple of years.
Sorry, you know, can't be too careful, you understand?
Roger that. So, what were we talking about? Rux, was it?
I've got the money and I've got that Sunday feeling. I like to sell about it and the feel of one. Oh, fuck. Come on, Trumpet, we're going to be late for work.
What'd you do?
Forest.
What, all of you?
Yeah.
Obviously. Except for Bill, of course.
Why? What'd you do, Bill?
Why are you so interested in what we all do? You undercover?
What?
Because if you are, you have to tell us.
It's the law. I don't think it is, Weasel, mate.
Oh, so you know all about it then, do you? Cozza?
Actually, he's quite right. Section 4, paragraph 2 of the Metropolitan Police Code of Conduct states that an officer only has to identify himself at a point of arrest. Apparently.
I don't know how he does it. He's a fountain of knowledge, this geezer. Where'd you get it all from? He's bailed you out there, son. That's when you owe him.
That's enough! No one's going to work today. Go home, sort yourselves out, and meet back at my house. Lively!
Dex, mate, I don't...
You don't what?
Nothing.
That's right, nothing. My house. Couple of hours. Savvy?
Sweet.
Feel rough.
Get cleaned up back at mine.
Thanks, Dex.
And don't worry about Bullet. You just don't like outsiders, that's all.
He seems to like Bill enough.
Yeah. Saying not quite right about that one.
Yeah, I thought that, I mean, you don't think he's...
I don't miss a trick, boy. The geezer's undercover. Undercover journal.
Sharon!
Who's that?
It's your husband.
Oh.
Now, don't you start crying, Princess.
Dexie, why didn't you call? I must look terrible.
No. You look beautiful.
Oh.
I've missed you so much.
We fucking missed you and all.
Where is it?
He's there, playing with his toys, waiting to meet his daddy. Well, go on then. Go and say hello.
Come on, mate, it's all right.
My boy. Apple didn't fall far from the tree, did it, then?
Ah, it's like two peas in a pod, mate.
I know. I used to sit and play with my toys as well, all the time. Grab it for me, babe. I want to hold it.
All right, babes. You are his daddy. His undisputed biological daddy.
Dex, you might as well be looking in the mirror, mate.
Yeah, I know. Two peas in a fucking pod. Dan, mate, you don't mind holding my kid for me, do you?
No, of course not, mate.
I'm just gonna go get some things for later, you know what I mean? Come on, babe.
Hey, what's his name?
It's fucking Curtis.
Of course it is.
Don't worry, babes. Your room's just how you left it.
That's my son. That picture was taken of us before I got sent down.
Oh, where is he, your son?
It was the mid-80s, and we were in our prime. No firm in London could touch us. It was the last game of the season, and we had one more firm to turn over.
I'm calling you out!
Well, here I am!
And we didn't think you'd show!
We've battered every firm in the country. Why wouldn't we show up to school a second-rate outfit like yours, you two-bob shithead?
We're in bandit country now! There ain't no going back!
South London? I'll shit 'em!
I see you brought your boy with you! Now you mind he don't get hurt!
Shut up, you mug!
Fucking little shit. You want some, Baron? Come fucking get some!
be about your age now. I swore that day I'd avenge my son's death and settle the score with the one person I hold accountable.
Hello, Dexter.
Baron!
So?
Finally found your way home, did you?
I just had to pick up a present for you.
Oh, yeah.
I got a little surprise waiting for you and all.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Don't waste my time, scum! What do you want?
All right, slow down, son. Just a courtesy call.
Just make sure you ain't gonna, bottle it tonight.
Oh. I wouldn't miss it for the world. I've been waiting a long time to be in the same room as you.
Well, do try and contain yourself. It's a gentleman's rendezvous this evening, not Tottenham away.
You'll keep. But when the time comes, Baron, I'm gonna open you up like a village fete, you saucy slag.
Dexie.
Don't bring another boy with you. Finished.
Finished. Hang up, fucking hell.
I'll get that, mate.
Oh, you're the fucking butler now, are you, Lunch?
Fucking mug.
Exactly.
I'll stick the kettle on, Dex.
Oh, fucking sweet!
Nunchucks!
Quite a collection you got there, Dex. I bet this lot have seen some action.
You're fucking right, yeah.
Ooh, this looks particularly nasty.
Well, of course it fucking is. Dex, you use that the stove in Jimmy Higgins' head. But you must have heard about that, Bill.
Yeah, I bet the gathers would like to get their hands on this bit of evidence.
Why are you so interested, Bill? You, writing a book, are you?
Filth! Come on. Who's the pig?
Finally, someone sees it.
Of course I see it. I could smell it as soon as I came down the stairs. Weasel! Look at the turnout you've left all over my Persian.
Fuck's
sake.
I'm sorry, Sharon. Sorry, Dex.
Now get your shoes off and take them outside. Hello. Ooh. Midnight.
Sharon. How's the little one?
He's good. Nice having his daddy in the house again.
I bet it is.
Hello, Sharon, love. How'd you take your coffee?
Black.
Like her men. Hey, boys. Hey.
Sharon, do me a favour and fuck off. I'll talk to the boys. So I trust you're all ready for the meet tonight.
Oh, we are now, mate.
You too, then. Yeah, mate.
Hold on, Dry Lunch. You want to run with the foxes, you've got to get blooded first.
What?
Now, Danny, I want you to put your hands together for my friend and yours, Stanley.
What are you going to do with that?
Oh, Jesus.
He won't help you.
That's poison, that is.
Don't bottle it in front of your new mate.
But if you're gonna fucking do it, then fucking do it. Right, fuck it. Give it here, I'll do it myself.
Oh! 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 Oh!
Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh!
Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh!
Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Are you gonna laugh?
What an ice cream, mate.
Birds will love it.
Thanks, mate. Can you do me a favour, Geese?
Well, anything. You're in the factory now, and
yeah.
Congratulations.
Great. Can you call me an ambulance?
To the 25th annual meet of the Hooligan Association of the United Kingdom. Come on! Yeah. Right then, I'd like to open up the floor to any new business. Yeah, the Honourable Gentleman from south of the river. That's you, Slasher.
My friends, I look around and I see a lot of new faces. Some of which I've slashed. Some of you I look forward to slashing in the seasons to come. My fellow hooligans, what I'm about to say concerns us all. Who in this room has got an autobiography coming out?
Oh, for fuck. This is what I'm talking about, Barry!
Oh, fucking sit in there!
What's not happening?
Sit down, Slasher. What we have here is what's known as market saturation. Henceforth, all book releases must be agreed to by myself. Move! Dexter. How lovely of you to join us.
I had to take one of mine to the hospital. But don't worry. What I've got to say won't take long.
Oh, good.
Now, there's over 4,000 Germans booked in for Europe this summer.
And they're going to steamroller us unless all our firms go together. With me as top boy.
Testing. 1-2-1-2.
Now, in the past, our firm has rumbled every single one of you lot. So I suggest it's me that leads the charge.
One minute, mate.
Who the fuck are you?
I'm Dex.
We are Dex, more like.
It's quite funny, actually.
What firm are you, anyway?
The village people, by the look of that moody tash.
You not heard? The 980s called. They want their clobber back.
Go on, mate. Take no notice of them. Which outfit are you?
The Hooligan Factory.
Yeah. Dio, anybody read that one?
No.
Go on then, Magnum PI. What's your book called?
I don't have a book.
You want to take us on tour, and you don't even have a book?
You don't have a book, you mug.
Look what a mug.
Ha, ha, ha.
mate.
What are you following me for? Hey, did you hear him in there? I'm a nobody, a fucking has-been. You're just a fucking kid. Go home, Dad. Just fucking go home.
I watch as the masses all gather, make sounds that in the end could change visions. Its shape is enough to touch heaven.
Your penthouse, did ya, you lemony fucking mug?
Now, fuck this.
Yeah, jog on, you melt.
Babe, what's the matter?
You think I'm all right, don't you, babe?
You're the bollocks.
You think?
Of course I do, you silly sod. You're a double-R bastard. Always have been, always will be. Now, come on, get up. There's someone here to see you.
Look, Danny White, you came here, you should go first.
But mate, I just wanted to say sorry.
Me too. I shouldn't have gone off on you like that. It's bang out of order.
Sweet. Let's forget about it and walk under the bridge.
So what do we do now then? It's just I've never really apologised for anything before.
Oh, you know, we could hug.
Mm. Yeah, we could do that.
I've missed you.
I miss you too, mate.
Yeah, it's my boy. That's a good boy. That's a good boy. It's good, good boy.
Oh, you're fucking killing me, you pair of melts.
Well, look, Dex, you still want to get back on top?
More than anything.
Good, because I've got a plan.
Let's kick you out.
Sweet.
Yeah.
That's my...
Fuck it.
I mean, it ain't normally my usual thing.
Oh, all right, all right. Don't like it, you don't like it. Not a problem, mate.
Oh, now this. That's a proper fucking bit of garment, mate. Oh, right, mate. I've got an idea.
Oh, God.
Plan was as simple as it was brilliant. We'd get back on top the old-fashioned way by taking the fight to them, one firm at a time. But travelling around the country don't come cheap, and no bank was going to lend us money to kick fuck out of someone. So to put a bit of extra cash our way, we all started working the door at one of London's roughest clubs, the Bear Pit.
Get out of the club, you little dollop of shit!
Fuck you lot! These clubs are fucking shithole! I'll get my guys come back and fucking screw you! Welcome to the fucking neighbourhood!
Hey, sluts. What's happening?
Needless to say, we took to it like ducks to water.
Tempo! Tempo! You fucking ripper!
Within a week, we had the place on lockdown. No more gangsters, no more drug dealers. But there was only one problem.
You charming thing.
For some reason, the punters just stopped coming. And the work dried up. But we soon found out running doors weren't the only way to make money. There's more than one use for hired muscle. Guarding packages, minding drug deals.
Where's all the cocaine?
Me and the lads got paid to make sure things went down how they should. Well, no one minds laying out an extra 10% for peace of mind. And soon, people started to come to us for all sorts.
You're unbelievable.
So what the fuck are we doing out here? What do you want from us?
Well, basically, mates, what it is, we're just looking for someone to keep an eye on things. Keep out the wrong elements, if you know what I mean.
Good job you called us, then. Because cracking heads is what we do best, isn't it, boys?
Yeah.
No, Mr. Dex, you misunderstand. Charles and I abhor violence. What we're trying to create here is an environment of love, an environment where people from all walks of life can come together and dance and sing and love, free from the shackles of oppression.
Puff's night, is it then?
No, Mr. Dex.
What's that? Drugs?
Oh, this isn't drugs, darling. This is pure love.
What the fuck are I doing?
So, what have they been taking? Tablets.
We were on our way.
Right, let's have ya.
With the money we made from being dormant, we had more than enough to pay for a shitload of those happy pills, and we sold them at raves up and down the country. It was the easiest money we ever made. We hired a bus and a shitload of extras and began to tour England, tearing up the firms one by one. But I still had one problem. Bullet.
All right, Dex.
What?
Oh, I'm sorry, Dan. Can't show the two of you apart nowadays. Funny. I remember when we first met. You remember that, don't you? Lunch. Let me fill you in. You might dress like Dexy, but the only reason you're here is because you remind him of his dead son. In case you're wondering, that's me there, right at the top. And it ain't alphabetical.
Fucking broke my glasses! What the fuck was that for? He's a bit keen, isn't he, Dex?
He's new!
He's mental! Oh, hey! This is supposed to be the verbal, son. You can't just go around hitting people.
Sorry.
Don't say sorry to me. It's him whose glasses you broke.
Yeah, I'm sorry about that.
You all right?
That's all right.
Sure?
Yeah.
All right. Now, where were we? Oh, yeah. Come on, everybody!
Bastards, you know Stanley?
Nah, mate. You know my little friend Makita?
We should be through.
boys, what's the matter with you?
I'm sorry, thanks, mate.
Get turned over by a fucking has-been!
He told me to give you this.
You have been steamrolled by a fucking...
What are you gonna do with
that? Something I should have done a long time ago.
You can't bring a gun to a rock.
Says who?
Just can't. Not cricket.
Fuck cricket! This is football!
I can't believe we did it. We got the top firm. I go down the shops, I get straight in the front of the queue. Pop down the booze and people are buying me drinks. Feel like a legend. Like me old man.
Yeah, well, we're not the top firm yet.
Right, mate.
Oh, midnight. You, want to come in or something?
No, I'm sound, bruv. Listen, Dex, I can't come with a final rock.
What are you talking about?
I'm looking to get out. Going straight. Got a geezer who said he was sorting me out with a job. A proper job. Not a florist. Dex. I got a kid to support.
No, you don't.
No. You're right. I don't. It's just... Ever since that night at the rave...
Oh, I knew it. I knew it.
I can't even look you in the eye no more. And my heart's not in it.
Midnight. They need you. I need you.
Sorry, mate.
Midnight! Midnight! Midnight.
Dex, mate, it's the phone. It's important.
It's the Baron.
Baron!
Hello, Dexter.
I do hope I'm not calling at an inconvenient time.
Shut it, Baron! Give me the where and the when.
3 p.m. kickoff.
Where?
Well, call me sentimental and all that.
But one place does spring to mind. I think you know where. Dad! Yeah. I know.
You okay, mate?
Danny, I don't want you coming to the final ruck.
What do you mean?
Look, you've done great so far. But this ain't Ipswich away. These lot mean business.
I thought I was part of something. I thought you needed me.
I do. More than you know.
Well, then why are you taking this away from me?
Look, Dan. I've already lost one son. I am not losing another.
I'm not your son, Dex.
Danny.
No, mate. I'm my own man.
You're just a kid.
You will fuck you, Dex. You wouldn't even be here if it weren't for me.
It's quiet. It's almost too quiet.
Maybe they bottled it.
Something all too familiar about this, eh, Dexter? Oh, and I see you brought another boy with you. Ain't you learnt nothing from the last time?
What are you doing here, Dan? I told you not to come.
Fuck off, Baron, you kimono-wearing clown. I'll open you up like a tin of beans.
Well, he's got some stones on him, your boy. I'll give him that. Well, you listen to me, boy. As soon as I'm done with the old man, I'm coming for you, you fucking pinhead.
You'll have to go through me first.
You never back down, do you, boy?
Nah, I always stand me ground.
Oh, it's all very touching, Dexter. So, any last words?
I'm sick of talking, Baron.
Let's do this.
Fuck me! Dance. It's for my son!
Dex! Drop him out! He ain't worth it.
Midnight. Look after little fucking Curtis for me.
I will.
Like he was your own.
Like he was my own.
Boys, it's been emotional. Now.
So, which one of you wants to tell us what happened?
Fuck you, cousin. We ain't talking.
Okay. Maybe you'll feel a bit more comfortable speaking to an old friend. Bill, can you come in here, please?
Hello, 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 boys.
How does he know your name, Bill?
Of course I know his name. He's a fucking face, ain't you, Bill? Tell him, Bill.
Bullet, I'm a police officer.
You can't be. You fucking ain't old Bill.
Danny, can you come with me, please?
That's right. Going together. Solidarity! Don't tell him nothing, boys! Boys! Right. One of you's obviously grassed. Which one is it?
Dan, I'm sorry about what happened to Dex. I know he meant a lot to you.
Thanks.
Listen, Dan. I know you're not stupid, so I'm going to tell this to you straight. It's not you I'm after. It's that line there.
Okay.
So consider this your lucky day. All charges against you have been dropped. You're free to go.
Really?
But if I even get a whiff that you've been in any kind of trouble at all, I'm going to come down on you like a ton of bricks. Do you understand me?
Dex's death, tragic though it was, taught me one thing. Life's funny. You can be up one minute and dead the next. But remember, if someone gives you a second chance, always take it, because you may not get another. Fuck you, Kozza! Was it all worth it? Of course it fucking was.
Strolling along, minding my own business. Well, there goes a girl and a half. She's got me going up and down. She's got me going up and down. Walking on the beaches, looking at the beach. Girl, that you got some suntan lotion in that bottle of yours. Spread it all over my peeling skin, baby. That feels real good. All the skirt, lapping up the sun. Lap me up. Why don't you come on and lap me up? Walking on the beaches, looking at the beaches. Just lying down on the sand dunes. I better go take a swim and see if I can cool down a little bit.
You're unbelievable.